On the South Shore of Long Island, there was a pretty notorious scandal recently involving animal abuse, where there was a dog trainer who someone took an undercover video of him aggressively jabbing a caged dog. I actually have a picture of it here so you could see what people were seeing on the televisions at night, and it really brought, you know, shock and awe to a lot of people in the area. And a lot of them came to me with the question, how is it that people hold themselves out as professional dog trainers if there is no such licensing scheme? And when I began to talk to people about this, you know, obviously people's pets are extensions of their families, if not outright parts of their families, and they thought that they were giving their loved ones over to people who had some type of professional training or had some type of oversight where someone was looking to make sure that they were compliant with some type of standard, and they were shocked to see none existed. So I've put in legislation that would have ag and markets do that, but certainly there's a lot that you could do short of legislation in terms of getting involved in this area, and whatever that may mean to you in terms of making sure that this is not happening. So I just wanted to ask if you were aware of it and see if you had any ideas that would be able to protect our beloved pets.
Yeah, nothing will strike at somebody's heart quicker than watching that. You know, no animal, no dog certainly, or any animal deserves to be treated cruelly, and we do have laws to that effect. Currently, our jurisdiction doesn't cover obedience training facilities unless they board the animals, or grooming facilities for that matter. So I'm not sure what the jurisdiction would lie with Secretary of State or not. I'd have to look into that. We do monitor shelters and breeders, and we do work with that population to make sure there is sanitation and appropriate safety measures, et cetera, in place there. Enforcement of any challenges is done by local law enforcement or local ASPCA. I'd be happy to speak with you about that, because one of our efforts that we have ongoing is working with the ASPCA as well as criminal justice to help identify what the standards should be, what they look like, and educating them on when they see animal cruelty. But be happy to speak with you further about that.
No, I appreciate that. And I think the whole idea behind any regulatory scheme would be to do something so we're not at the point where the ASPCA and animal cruelty is being discussed, so that people know, you know, where the line is and who has met some sort of rigor that they are allowed to be given your animals. So I'd love you to explore the boundaries of your jurisdiction and what you think can be done, all in the name of protecting our pets.
Understood. Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your time.